We're going to talk about lines being parallel, which is a particular relationship that two lines can have. Let's start with a definition. Two lines in the plane are parallel if they never intersect with each other. And let's see if we can get a handle on what exactly that means. So let's start by drawing a random line. And then let's see if we can draw another line that never intersects it. We kind of have an inkling that if a line is never going to intersect our black line here, it's going to have to run kind of in the same direction as that black line. But let's see if we can be a little more specific. If I draw a line that is steeper than the black line, then it's pretty clear that somewhere up here, they're going to have to intersect, so these two lines can't be parallel. On the other hand, if I draw a line that is shallower than the black line, then it's pretty clear that they would have to intersect somewhere down here, and so a shallower line can't be parallel either. So a parallel line can't be steeper than our black line, and it can't be shallower than our black line. Well, what does that mean? It means that the slope of our parallel line has to be exactly the same as the slope of our original line. And this gives us the more practical characteristic of parallel lines. Two lines are parallel if they have the same slope. Now let's get more specific. In this example, we are told to find the equation of a line that passes through the point 2, negative 1 and is parallel to the line that is graphed here. Now, to find the equation of a line, we need a point, which we were given, but we also need a slope, and this is where our graphed line comes in. Looking at our picture, we see that our graphed line passes through the point negative 3, negative 5, and the point 1, 7. We can count up and over to determine the slope between those two points. So counting up, we see that the distance vertically is 12, and the distance horizontally is 4. So when we set up our slope, that's going to be the rise, which is 12, over the run, which is 4. Well, 12 divided by 4 is 3. So the graphed line has a slope of 3. The line that we're looking for is parallel, and therefore it must also have a slope of 3. Now we're in a position to find the equation because we have a slope and we have a point. So let's use the point-slope form. Y equals m, which is 3, times x minus x1, which is 2, plus y1, which in this case is going to be minus 1. From here, we can clean this up into the slope-intercept form by distributing the 3 inside the parentheses. If we do that, what we get is y equals 3 times x is 3x, 3 times negative 2 is negative 6, minus 1. Y equals 3x minus 7. So if you want, we can even graph our line now. We know that it has a y-intercept of negative 7, and it has a slope of 3, so we can go up 1, 2, 3, and over 1. And if we connect our dots, we should end up with a line that is parallel to the line that is already on the page. Let's do another example. In this question, we are once again given a point, 3, 4, and we're asked to find a line that goes through that point and is parallel to this line, 2x plus 4y equals 7. In cases like this, it's important to make a distinction between the information about the line that we're given and the information about the line that we want. So let's write those two things separately. On one side, we'll put information about the line that we are given, and on the other side, we will put information about the line that we want. the line that we want should go through the point 3, comma 4. The line that we are given is the equation 2x plus 4y equals 7. In order to come up with the equation for the line we want, we have a point. The thing that we need is a slope. Well, if we can determine the slope of the line that we are given, that will have to be the same as the slope of the line we want because the two lines are parallel. We can find the slope of our given line by doing a little bit of algebra to put it into the slope-intercept form. So we would start by subtracting 2x from both sides, and that leaves us with 4y equals negative 2x plus 7. Now to get rid of the 4, we divide both sides by 4. And what we're left with is y equals 2 over 4 simplifies to 1/2 x plus 7 over 4. Now that we have the slope-intercept form, we know that the slope of our given line is negative 1/2. This is the important information that we needed. Since our lines are parallel, they must have the same slope, and so now we know that the slope of the line we want is also negative 1/2. Now we are ready to find the equation of the line we want. We can start with the point slope form. Y equals m times x minus x1 plus y1. And we can distribute the negative 1/2 inside the parentheses, which gives us y equals negative 1/2 x. Negative 1/2 times positive 3 is plus 3 over 2. And then 4 is the same as 8 over 2. Adding those two numbers together gives us the slope-intercept form of our line. Y equals negative 1/2 x plus 11 over 2.